Hello learners, welcome to the NIOS studios. I'm Dr. Abha Sharma from School of Education, G.D. Goenka University. Now going to discuss important points on educational agencies. We very well know that education not only shapes the behavior of the individuals, but also helps in transformation of rich cultural heritage to the rising generation. Therefore, society establishes and develops institutions for achieving and shaping of behavior in a desirable direction and passing on cultural heritage to the successive generation. These institutions are called sources or agencies of education. More precisely, society has created a number of specialized institutions to carry out these functions of education. These institutions are known as agencies of education, sources through which the child directly or indirectly receives education, formal and informal, are called educational agencies. So learners, today we are going to discuss on important educational agencies. So today's discussion will be focused on meaning of educational agencies, important educational agencies, which includes National Council of Educational Research and Training, the National Council for Teacher Education, National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, State Council of Educational Research and Training, and District Institutes of Education and Training. So switching to the meaning of educational agencies, we very well know that society establishes some of the institutions to maintain its continuity of life. For the continuity and development of its life, society counts upon education. Education not only shapes the behavior of the individuals, but also helps in transformation of rich cultural heritage to the rising generation. Therefore, society establishes and develops institutions for achieving the modification of behavior and passing on cultural heritage to the successive generation. Now, these agencies are National Council of Educational Research and Training, that is NCERT, the National Council for Teacher Education, that is NCTE, National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, that is NCPCR, State Council of Educational Research and Training, that is SCERT, and District Institutes of Education and Training, that is DIETS. So first of all, we will discuss about NCERT. NCERT is an autonomous organization which was set up in 1961 by the Government of India. It assists and advises the central and state governments on the policies and programs to improve the quality of school education. As a nodal agency for achieving goals of universalization of elementary education, it also networks with state educational departments, universities, NGOs, and other educational institutions to meet its following objectives. The objectives are to administer basic childhood education, to encourage education of girl child, to promote value education, to work for education of students with special needs, to implement a national framework curriculum, to provide vocational education, to assess, examine and reform IT education, to bring universalization of fundamental education, to produce a teaching and learning experience, to improve thought and attention of learners, and to advance teacher education. Now, the NCERT came out with the National Curriculum Framework in 1988. It was published in response to the desire expressed in the National Policy on Education, 1986, that the implementation of education policy and emergent trends in education should be reviewed periodically. Subsequently, two NCFs have been published in 2000 and 2005. The NCF provides a framework for designing of curriculum, creation of textbooks and classroom pedagogy under the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009, the NCERT has been appointed as the academic authority to lay down the curriculum and evaluation procedure for elementary education and to lay down a framework for national curriculum. Next comes the National Council for Teacher Education, that is NCTE. NCTE was established in 1973 as an advisory body on all matters pertaining to teacher education for the central and state governments. On the 17th of August 1995, NCTE was given a statutory status under the National Policy on Education, that is NPE, formulated in 1986. Under the Right to Education, NCTE has been appointed as the authority to lay down the minimum qualification for a person to be appointed as a teacher. Role of NCTE. Now, we are going to discuss about the role of NCTE, which is to achieve planned and coordinated development of the teacher education system through, first is curriculum planning of in-service training programs, monitoring of training programs, and initiating innovations in teacher education, regulation and proper maintenance of norms and standards in the teacher education system, research and training of persons for equip them to teach at pre-primary, primary, secondary, and senior secondary stages in schools, and non-formal education, part-time education, adult education, and distance or correspondence education courses. Next comes is National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, which is also known as NCPCR. National Commission for Protection of Child Rights was set up in March 2007 under the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act 2005. The NCPCR at the national level and the State Commission for Protection of Child Rights, that is SCPCR, at the state level ensures that all laws, policies, programs, and administrative mechanisms are in adherence to the rights of children as enshrined in the Constitution of India. Under the Right to Education RTE Act, the role of NCPCR is monitoring of child's right to education, inquire into complaints relating to child rights to free and compulsory education, advise the education agencies and other partners implementing educational programs on matters relating to children in need of special care and protection, which includes children in distress, marginalized and disadvantaged children, children in conflict with law, juveniles, children with family, without family, and children of prisoners. Recommended measures and norms to be implemented by schools, such as prohibiting discrimination, prohibiting physical punishment, and mental harassment of any child in school. Switching to next point, and the next agency, which is State Council of Educational Research and Training, that is SCERT, which came into existence on 5th of January 1979 as a result of transformation and upgradation of the former State Institute of Education, that is SIE. The main aim of their activities is to acquaint the teachers with the innovations brought out in the field of school education through teachers' training programs and workshops. The functions of SIERT are to organize and implement the special educational projects sponsored by UNICEF, NCERT, and other agencies for qualitative improvement of school education and teacher educators, to prescribe curricula and textbooks for the school and teachers training institutes, to organize programs which includes correspondence cum contact courses for professional development of teachers and teacher educators and inspiring officers, to supervise the working of the teacher training colleges, secondary training schools, and elementary training schools. Activities of SCRT are organize in-service training programs for teachers, administrators and teacher educators, implement new educational techniques and methodologies, coordinate with DIETS and impart guidance, develop teaching learning material for various training programs to get it printed, coordinate with various State Council of Education, NCERT or NIEPA. Switching to the next agency, that is State Commission for Protection of Child Rights. At the state level, the State Commission for Protection of Child Rights is the main agency to inquire into complaints of violation of child rights. The State Commission for Protection of Child Rights are to be established in each state as per the provisions of the Commissions for Protection of Child Rights Act 2005. They are expected to be set up to protect, promote, and defend child rights in each state. The commission consists of a chairperson and 6 members who are well versed in child welfare. At least one member should be a woman. The state commission is required to submit an annual report to the state government as well as special reports when an issue needs immediate attention. The district elementary education officer is in charge of the administration of elementary education in the district. Some of his or her main functions are maintain a record of all children in the jurisdiction till they complete 14 years of age, ensure that schools in the district fulfill the required norms and standards through monitoring and on-site inspection, oversee functioning of schools and teachers in the district, oversee appointments and transfers of teachers, rationalization of teachers, look into promotions, complaints, fifth class examination, seniority and confirmation and priority cases, oversee recognition of private schools, oversee medical reimbursement of teachers, oversee grants in aid to aided schools. The last educational agency is District Institute of Education and Training, that is DIET. Under the National Policy on Education, NPE, on teacher education, the central government allocated funds to set up DIETs in October 1989 to provide academic and resource support at the grassroots level for the success of the various strategies and programs being undertaken in the areas of elementary and adult education. Placed under the District Board of Education, DBE, DIETs are closely linked with education agencies and NGOs at the national, state, divisional and district levels, whose objectives and interests converge with its own. DIETs function throughout the year and are mainly residential institutes. The role of DIET is to promote universalization and enhance the quality of primary or elementary and adult education by providing training and orientation through pre-service and in-service education to the following groups: elementary school teachers, headmasters, head of the school complexes and officers of education department up to block level, instructors and supervisors of non-formal and adult education, members of district board of education and village education committee, community leaders, youth and other volunteers working in the field of education. Engage resource persons to conduct suitable programs for the groups mentioned above at centers other than the DIETs. Provide academic and resource support to the elementary and adult education system in the district. Action-based research to deal with specific problems of the district in achieving the objectives in the areas of elementary and adult education. So students, Today, we have discussed the important points, that is, meaning of educational agencies, important educational agencies, which includes National Council of Educational Research and Training, the National Council for Teacher Education, National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, State Council of Educational Research and Training, District Institutes of Education and Training. Thank you very much.